In this video, I'm going to show you how to set the scale for printing the cabin project. When you finish drawing the floor plan and the elevations of the cabin project, you're going to switch over to paper space and print these two sheets. Start by clicking on the floor plan tab in the lower left corner. This will take you over into paper space for the setup that's already built into the prototype. If you look at your screen, you will see that there is an orange rectangle, and that rectangle represents the edges of a viewport, and the viewport is how we see back into paper space when we're in, see back into model space when we're in paper space. So we click on the orange rectangle and look at the status bar in the lower right corner. Move this up, and you'll see a string of numbers in here, and these numbers represent the scale of the viewport. Now, if this lock is blue, you'll have to pick on that lock and unlock it. But once you've selected the viewport, look at this string of numbers and pick on the down arrow. All of the scales available to you are here, and the scale for this project is 3/16 of an inch equals 1 foot. So you'll pick on that. And that's going to change the scale of what we're seeing inside the viewport to 3/16 equals 1 foot. Now, it may not be centered the way you want it to be. So what you want to do next is you're going to come inside the whites area and double click with your left click button, which actually puts you into model space. Now you can hold down the wheel of your mouse, and you can move your view until you get it centered inside the border. So you want to look for things like, you want to make sure that the notes for the floor plan and the wall thickness are not off the border, right up against the border. You also want to make sure that the top dimension is not right against the border up here, and you kind of want to look at your spacing on the sides here. Once you like where it's located at, you want to come back to your 3/16 and you want to pick on the lock. And what that does is it locks the viewport. So now if I scroll in or out with the mouse wheel, it does not change the scale of what is inside here. If I want to change the scale or move this or do anything, I need to get out of model space just by picking on the word model. That's one way to do it. Or double click out here into the gray space. But if you click on that, select the viewport and unlock it. And at that point, you can double click inside the white area and you can scroll in and out. And again, you can change the scale or whatever you want. So I'll go ahead and do that. Take it out of scale, bring it back to 3/16. Double click inside that area. Hold down the mouse wheel. Move the view until I like its location. I'm going to double click out here into the gray and select the viewport and lock it. I'll do the same thing on the elevations. I'm going to click on the elevations tab. I'm going to select the viewport, pick on the scale, choose 3/16. You can see that part of my cabin project is over there inside my title block. So I'll double click in the white area, hold down with the mouse, move it over. Now, one thing, it's live. And if you roll that wheel any, it's going to change the scale. So I'll have to get back into paper space, pick on the viewport, and change the scale back to 3/16. Now, you have to be kind of careful in here because you can see that I'm really close to the border there. Let me click out here and get back into paper space. When I zoom in here, I'm really close over here, and I have a little bit of room over here on this side. The key is this space between the two views. It can't be too far apart and it can't be too close, or it'll be kind of crowded. So again, you can double click and get back into paper space there and drag it just a little bit, sort of center it up. And let's double click and get into paper space and zoom out a bit. Okay, so you can also adjust the height of where it is on the screen. If you want to lower it a little bit, you could double click in there and maybe drag it down just a little bit. Now you don't want to do that, but actually it's I've got it centered now, so it should zoom right back in. Well, it didn't quite, but I get it where I want it. And double click out here into paper space. Click the viewport and I want to lock it right there. All right, so now I'm ready to plot. So when I pick on the plotter, I want to come up here and choose a plotter. Now, if I'm plotting it just one sheet at a time, this is how I do it. I could do the Adobe PDF. I want to make sure that I'm printing 11 by 17. I want to make sure this is monochrome over here in my color settings. I want to plot the layout, and I want to preview that. And so looks like that there's something weird set up with my printer. So what I could do to move things along the X and Y and move that print over to the right and up a little bit is I could put some values in here. And if I give this, let's say I say that I want this to be 0.25. And let's see, I've got an extra. And let's preview that. And what that does is it moves the entire view over a little bit. And I can see that I probably want to move it up and to the right some more. So I would close that. And again, I would keep adding some numbers in here if I needed to get that moved over to where I want it to be. Now, the other option that you have for printing this, I'm going to cancel this, would be what's called a batch plot, where you print multiple sheets. And to do that, move this over a little bit. You can come up here and pick on this red A right up here. Come down to print. You don't have to pick on that, and some options will fly out. Come up here and pick on batch plot. Now you can see I have a whole bunch of sheets. I think you won't have as many sheets as this, but this one that says right here, this sheet would be model. I don't want to print model space. So you pick on it, select it, and then you can pick right here and pick remove sheets. What I do want to pick are the floor plan and the elevations. But if I don't want to print other sheets, I can select all of those and remove them. And so this will allow me to print the floor plan and the elevations into one PDF. So this PDF will have two sheets. And I want to set everything up, get everything set up the way that it needs to be. And usually that right down in here, it's going to say that this is set up for 11 by 17. So whatever your print setup is going to be. And I'm just going to pick publish. And the option I'll be given, because I'm printing this as a PDF, is to locate a folder and give it a name and then go ahead and print it as a PDF file. So that's how you'll print. At the end, it's going to say, do you want to save the current list of sheets? You can pick yes or no. If you pick yes, you'll be asked for a location to save it. But I can pick no right there. When it starts to print, down here on the status bar, there's a printer icon. And that will appear, and it will be sort of blinking as long as it takes to publish that set of PDF prints, if that's what you're printing. So, and when that goes off, it will tell you that the print job is finished. Okay, I hope this helps you with set up your printing.